Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever in the world you are. I am in Dar es Salaam, Tanzania, once again. For those of you who have been following my channel, you know that I came to Tanzania in March 2020, when all the lockdowns in the world began. Tanzania had no lockdown, ever. I went around Southern Africa since then, and I'm back again because I'm on my way to the stunned countries. So I'm gonna be here for a while we're sorting things out. So Happy New Year to everybody. 2022, here we are. Who knows what's going to happen. Okay, so I've not been posting. Oh, by the way, rocking the natural nude and nice look. Just cut my hair. I'm gonna try to be let it grow out naturally this year. Of course, I'm saying this now. In 5 minutes' time, I might change my mind and then go and straighten my hair. Who knows? Anyway, so I've not been posting anything for quite some time because, you know, I only post controversial content. That nothing came up that has been controversial or well as far as I was concerned. But now, today, there is something. Well, it happened last week. Two things. But today I'm only going to address one. And this is Pope Francis, who says choosing pets over. Okay, the word here is kids, but a kid is a baby goat. Since we're talking about human beings, I'm going to talk about children. So choosing pets over children is selfish. Now, this is from the BBC. I did not watch the Pope's speech myself. This is mainstream media, BBC media, not to be trusted. But anyway, this is what they say he said. So maybe he didn't say all these things, maybe he did. Those people who watch the Pope, you will know. I'm just going off of here. So I'm going to give my 2 cents. Well, in my case, it's always a lot more than 2 cents concerning this matter. Now, the other thing is, this subject, I did not even have to research because I'm going to go off on my own observation in the world regarding this matter because, you know, I live in the world. Duh. I have friends, family, acquaintances. I see things, so I'm gonna go on what I see, what I know to be fact. Okay, right. So, first thing it says here is that Pope Francis has suggested people who choose to have pets over children are acting selfishly. Okay, so of course, the whole internet, when he said this, they went up into uproar. Well, not everybody, because a lot of people agree with him, but there were also that camp that was totally against what he said. And I can believe that because I personally have family members and good friends who would be up in arms over these things that he says. Because I know them. I know what they think. I know what they say about this matter. I know. Because they're my friends and my family. So everything I'm talking about here now is things that I actually really know. First person perspective, okay? Right. So the Pope's comments came as he was discussing parenthood during a general audience at the Vatican in Rome. So of course it would make sense he'll be talking about something like this because he's talking about parenthood. So of course owning a pet doesn't make you a parent. It makes you a pet owner. Hello? Okay. So already just by that, parenthood, we know it's going to be children, parents and children. Because to be a parent, you have to have a child. If you don't have a child, you are not a parent. That's just how it works. Okay, today we see a form of selfishness. This is what he said, apparently. He told the audience, we see that some people do not want to have a child. Yeah, I've seen a lot of that. And I mean, again, that's, I think, a human being's prerogative, because not everybody wants to have children, because some of us already know that we are just not going to be good parents, because we all know ourselves. Some of us know that we are violent, we are abusive, or we would neglect the child, or you know, you don't know the right person to have a child with. It's not, having a child is something that has to be, you have to sit quietly and consider it. It's not just like I want to buy a doll. It doesn't work like that. So that makes sense that some people don't want to have children. Sometimes they have one and that's it. Like me, I have one and that's it. but they have dogs and cats that take the place of children. Okay, yeah, now, so that's not me. I don't have dogs or cats. My son has cats, and they did not replace children because we got them after menopause, so they're not replacing. They are pets. To me, they are just pets. They do not replace a child because a child is a human being. I can say that I know enough of biology and science to know the difference between a pet, an animal, and a child, a human being. So to me, a pet, a cat, a dog is not a child. Although I only have one child, if I do have a cat or a dog, it's not because I'm replacing them with a child, because like I said, I know biology. But I do know a lot of people who do that. And for those people who are up in arms over him saying that, because you know it's true. Well, if you're my friend and my family member who has spoken to me, you know it's true. Okay, so. Then he goes on saying, this may make people laugh, but it is a reality. Uh-huh. You're right, Pope. You are so right. Oh, by the way, my second name is also Francis, so maybe we think alike because we have the same name. The practice is a denial of fatherhood and motherhood and diminishes us, takes away humanity, he added. Okay, now he is more deep than I am. I have never considered it in this way because I'm not as deep as he is. And you know, the Pope is like on a different spiritual level than I think the majority of us, definitely than me. But after he said it is a denial of fatherhood and motherhood, I tend to agree. Because replacing a pet with a child is denying humanity. Because humanity means human. So when you replace a human and you prioritize an animal over a human, you are diminishing us. Because you are diminishing human beings by putting animals above human beings. And I know there's a lot of you, and I know because you're my friends and my family, that think animals are the same as humans. Like I said, I know biology. It doesn't work like that because I've had my cat for years, but I cannot sit down with my cat and have a discussion about art because my cat has no interest in art other than scratching the art piece or peeing on it. Different level. Then someone might say, oh, wait, you can't even do that with a child. While they cannot talk, you can't, but as they get older, you can. By the time they're six, they can have an opinion over an art piece. Right? As they get more educated, they can even give more opinions. A cat, doesn't matter how educated it is, it's not going to have an opinion. It's just going to pee all over the artwork. So, okay. Pope Francis said that people who are unable to have children for biological reasons should consider adoption, urging people not to be afraid in embarking on parenthood. Go, Pope, go, Pope. I totally agree. And I am so thankful that I actually know people, I have friends who have done that. They cannot have their own children, so they have adopted children. Yeah, okay, so in 2014, he said that having pets instead of children was another phenomenon of cultural degradation, and that emotional relationships with pets was easier than the complex relationship between parents and children. Yeah, this I also can believe, because having a pet is much easier, because like example, let's say if you have a cat, you just feed them and take them to the vet when they're sick, but otherwise they're just on their own. A dog needs a little bit more attention, but still, if you abuse it physically, emotionally, actually you can't abuse it emotionally because I don't think, maybe you can, but I don't know, I've never heard of it. The dog is, nothing's going to happen to the dog. He'll just die, and then if he dies, he's just dead. And if you don't want the dog, you can just give it away to your friend or just leave it out in the street, just dump it somewhere. You can't do that with a child. So it is easier. to have a dog, which or a cat, which means that shows that it is selfish, and it is a phenomenon of cultural degradation, right? Because if you choose an animal over a human being, something is not right. But then I know maybe some people are more in touch with the animal side, because I know I have friends who are zoophiles. A zoophile is someone who actually falls in love with an animal and who treats the animal like a lover. In some countries this is illegal, but it's a paraphilia. It's a disorder. So I'm sure there's those people who are more intact with the animal side, so they, to them, an animal is, they have more affinity with an animal, so that is why they see an animal as their child. Okay? That could also be a disorder, I don't know. So we cannot say what the levels are of why people do what they do. Okay, the other thing that we must take note of is that, remember when Pope Francis is talking, he's talking to the Catholic people. So if you're not Catholic, then just don't listen. If you feel this is offending you, then don't listen, because this is not for you. This is actually for Catholic people, because the Pope is the head of the Vatican, which is the Catholic Church. Okay? Yeah, so don't get your panties into a little knot, because if you're not Catholic. But if you're Catholic, this is for you. You must listen. If you don't like it, then move on and don't be a Catholic. Don't be a Catholic. Okay? Right. Yeah, the other thing is, and I know with friends that I have who will say straight to my face, I love animals more than people. Yeah, I see you. I understand you. Like I said, you could be in touch with your animal side. You're more animal than human. Because, I mean, who knows? You know, evolutionary biology. I don't know. I'm not a scientist, evolutionary biologist, so I don't know. But it makes sense that some people would probably be more, like I said earlier on, more in touch with their animal side. And because... So how I handle these kind of people is, like, I have friends and family who say this. So I just know I would never go on safari with these kind of people, because, like, in the unlikely event that I get mauled by a lion, these people are more likely to shoot me than to shoot the lion. Because to them, the lion's life is worth more than human life. So if you have such a friend or family member, do not go on safari with them. Okay, but on the other hand, my friends, you know, if you go with me and my family, if anything had to happen to you, even if it was my own dog attacking you and your life was at risk, I would kill my own dog to save you. Okay, right. So the 85-year-old Pope, oh, is that old already, has been photographed petting animals ranging from dogs to panthers in the past, but he is not thought to have a personal pet. So I don't know what that has got to do with this whole saga. Maybe because people are saying he doesn't like animals. That's why he speaks like that. No, me, I love animals. And anyone who knows me, I love them so much that I don't eat them. People who know me will know I love animals. But I also understand that an animal is an animal and a human being is a human being. A child is a human baby. And a dog is an animal. Two different things. I do not conflate the two. I keep it in perspective. So he doesn't have a pet, maybe because he's old. Why does he need a pet? He's taking care of the human population. He doesn't have time. But he loves animals, okay? Right, his 2015 visit to the United States was marked by dog owners dressing their pets in canine papaw outfits with a hashtag Pope Dog on Instagram. Ah, that's cute. That's cute. I mean, I don't even know why they're mentioning this, because this has got nothing to do with what he had to say. But I think it's just cute if you dress, because, you know, in honor of his visit to the U.S. that people dress their pets. I just think that's cute, so I don't have any issue with that. Asked at the time if the Pope was aware of this trend of dressing up animals, a Vatican spokeswoman said, "I imagine he has more important things to think about." I don't know, seeing this Pope, I would think he would think about that. And I think he would probably just think it's cute. Because that has got nothing to do with the fact that people are choosing pets over children. That's just another, that's like a totally different issue. That's a different subject altogether. So, but of course, in typical mainstream media fashion, they have to conflate things because they want us all to get riled up and then have a lot to say and then hate the Catholic Church and then hate religion and then hate God and then hate the Pope because God and the Pope doesn't like animals and pets and etc. because that's how they roll, right? Yeah, so this video is just going to be about this. It's a spontaneous video because it's the first video of the year. I don't know what else to say. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to look for actual responses, what people had to say about this. And then I will give my opinion regarding that, okay? So anyway, everybody, have a good day. I'm going to the beach now. Cheers.